Hello and welcome. Microsoft Graph and PowerShell script offer robust capabilities for task automation, executing batch operations, and maintaining consistency for your settings and configurations across different environments like test, pre-production, and production. My name is Yoel Orbit, a product manager with the Microsoft Identity Product Group. This video will cover the fundamentals of automation and continuous integration with Microsoft Entra External ID in external tenants. There are benefits in fast release cycles, enhanced change management, and stabilizing the deployment process. Microsoft Graph serves as a gateway to data available with Microsoft 365 and Microsoft Entra. Through its web API, PowerShell and client libraries for a variety of programming languages and platforms, it provides a means to handle data operations such as administration of users, groups, applications, and sign-in logs. It offers the capability to set up your Microsoft Entra External ID tenant, like enable the configuration of user flows, identity providers, conditional access policies, authentication methods, and more. Before Microsoft Identity Platform can authorize your application or script to access data in your Microsoft Entra External ID tenant through Microsoft Graph, the application or the script must be granted the privilege they need by assigning it Microsoft Graph permissions. Microsoft Graph supports two access scenarios, delegated access and application-only access. In delegated access, the application calls Microsoft Graph on behalf of the signed-in user. The permissions are called delegated permissions, often referred as scopes. They are permissions that allow the application to act on behalf of the signed-in user. However, the application will never be able to access anything that the signed-in user could not access by themselves. In application-only access, the application or PowerShell script calls Microsoft Graph with its own identity, without a sign-in user present. This type is commonly used for server-to-server interactions that must run in the background without immediate interaction with the user. The application or PowerShell script will be able to access any data that the permissions are associated with. Application permissions must be consented by the administrator. Let's start with a demo. For the demo, I will use Microsoft Graph Explorer at aka.ms/ge. It's a web-based tool that enables administrators and developers to build and test queries against Microsoft Graph. Sign in with your administrator account. After you signed in, check the tenant's name and make sure you are on the right one. Start with a simple query. This query is searched for all users who sign in with their Facebook account. It filters by the identities attribute contains any issuer equals to facebook.com. You may get an error message that requires you to consent to the required permissions. The reason behind this issue, it is not enough that you have the permissions to manage users in the directory, you should also grant the Graph Explorer permissions to act on behalf of yourself as explained in the introduction. Select the Modify Permissions tab. From the list of permissions, choose a least privileged one. If you only need to read users' attributes, choose the User Read All option. To update or delete users, choose the User Read Write All. Select the Consent button. If you are administrator, accept the permissions requested. Otherwise, ask your administrator to do it for you. Now that the Graph Explorer has the required permissions, run the query again. This time, it shows all users who sign in with Facebook account. The result shows their ID and display name. If you need more information, like their country, add it to the select parameter and run the query again. Various operations are available, such as create, update, or delete accounts in the directory. For example, copy the ID of a user, switch the HTTP method to delete, append the user ID to the URL following the user's object type, and execute the query. Once completed, the user will be successfully removed from the directory and cannot sign in. If you change the HTTP method to GET and try to read the account, it will fail. To learn more about the operations, from the header, select API, then API reference. From the menu, you can find the object types. Keep in mind that not all of the objects and operations are supported by Microsoft Entra External ID tenant, so always check the documentation. Select Users, then Overview. The Overview page shows the list of operations to run, alongside additional information about this type of the object, user. From the menu, choose the update operation. It shows the details about the operation. It starts with the permissions, both delegated permissions and application permissions. It shows the HTTP method and the endpoint. And then the request body. Usually, when you create or update an object in the directory, you need to supply certain details. The document comes with some examples, starting with the HTTPS we demonstrated, along with a variety of other options. This includes C# code, CLI commands, Go, Java, JavaScript, PHP, PowerShell, and Python, enabling the use of Microsoft Graph across different platforms, allowing you to automate the settings and management tasks by using PowerShell script or developing your own application using your preferred programming language. Microsoft Graph PowerShell exposes the entire Graph API set for use in PowerShell. It contains a set of commandlets that helps you manage identities at scale, from automating tasks to managing certain elements in the directory. For the demo, you register a web application in Microsoft Entra External ID. Registering an application involves series of common steps like registering the application itself, creating a service principal, granting admin consent, or create an app secret, or uploading a certificate, and sometimes modifying the application manifest. With Graph PowerShell, the application registration process is structured, quick, and easy to use. The Woodgrove Live demo contains a PowerShell script for your reference. Go to Woodgrove Demo at woodgrovedemo.com. From the right side of the screen, click on Select a Use Case button and select one of the use cases. To get the PowerShell script, select the Learn How We Configure the Woodgrove Tenant link. Select the Application Registration link. It shows the configuration step for using Microsoft Entra Admin Center, Graph API, and PowerShell. The PowerShell tab details the steps to register and configure a web application. Scroll down to find the complete PowerShell script. The PowerShell Add Web Application function first registers the application. In the JSON, you can specify the application display name, description, and also customize your application manifest, like set the value of the accept map claims attribute to true or the collection of the redirect URIs. Then it creates a corresponding service principal, grant admin consent for the delegated permissions, and an additional option to create an application secret. To run the PowerShell script, you first need to connect your tenant using the connect mg graph command and specify the scopes or permissions required to run the operations. And finally, run the add web application function defined by this script. Scroll up and copy the PowerShell script. Close or minimize the browser, then open PowerShell and paste the script. The connect mg graph command prompts you to sign in with your administrator account. Then accept the permission requested by the PowerShell, allowing PowerShell to run the script on behalf of yourself. When completed, close or minimize the browser. Run the add web application function, and the application was successfully created. You can get the application ID and the application secret. Now let's learn how to automate the graph operations. Continuous integration and continuous deployment allows changes in configurations to be rapidly tested, executed, and propagated the exact same configuration through all environments, beginning with your development tenant through until the production tenant. GitHub offers an amazing tool known as Workflow, which is a flexible automated procedure that is composed of one or more jobs. These jobs enable the execution of PowerShell script in response to specific events within your repository, like when you update a file with a PowerShell script. They can also be triggered manually or at a defined schedule. You can also store secrets for the GitHub workflow. Secrets are encrypted variables that can be used to store sensitive information like the tenant ID, client ID, and client secret of the application used for authentication, or variables that are used to store non-sensitive configuration information for the GitHub workflows, making your PowerShell script more flexible and reusable. Let me show you how it works. This GitHub repository contains a PowerShell script that creates or updates a conditional access policy. the PowerShell script defines the conditional access policy in a JSON format. If the conditional access policy exists, it will be updated. Otherwise, it will be created. Looking into the conditional access definition, the policy state is enabled. I'll open Microsoft Entra Admin Center to show you that the policy state is indeed enabled. Back to GitHub, switch to edit mode, and change the state to disabled. Then commit the changes, which will trigger the workflow that updates the conditional access policy in Microsoft Entra External ID tenant. Back to Microsoft Entra Admin Center, select Refresh to reflect the changes, and it shows now that the policy is disabled or off. GitHub workflows are stored in the GitHub repo, and you can have one or more workflows in your GitHub repo. This example workflow reads the workflow secrets, the tenant ID, the client ID, and client secret used to connect to the Microsoft Entra External ID tenant. Do you remember there are two types of permissions? Delegated permissions are when a user runs a Graph API or Graph PowerShell. Application permissions are used in application-only access scenario without assigning user present. Therefore, the script which runs in the background acts on behalf of the application itself using application permissions and application credentials, also known as client credentials flow. In this video, we explore the advantages of leveraging the Microsoft Graph API and Microsoft Graph PowerShell, and streamline the deployment process through GitHub workflows. The benefits of automation in minimizing integration and deployment issues, faster release cycles, and improving the change management and versioning control, ensuring consistency across various environments. Microsoft Graph supports a variety of programming languages such as C#, PHP, and JavaScript that can be easily integrated into the CI/CD and deployment platforms like GitHub workflows and Azure pipelines. For further information on this subject, please refer to the link provided in the description below. Thanks for tuning in, and see you soon.